Pollution is a subject of continuing concern to all of us. It is a subject we cannot avoid, for all of us, by the fact that we live and breathe, are sufferers from and contributors to pollution.
Everybody's downwind of somebody, and to be able to do some research in one part of the world and have it affect somebody somewhere else is just amazing. Our group goes around the world and takes air samples, and those air samples are used either to study urban pollution. We study gases that are greenhouse gases. We also study gases that can affect stratospheric ozone. The last time we flew 42,000 miles in 23 days, it was an Around the World project where we flew the NASA DCA from the North Pole to over Antarctica, looking at what the air looks like, because the air had never been sampled with that kind of rigor before. Back in 1991, the mayor of Mexico City said, "We have an air quality problem. Could you help us out?" So we took some air samples, and that ended up leading to some research that pointed out that a considerable amount of the air pollution, ozone-wise, in Mexico City was coming from leaky tanks that people had at their homes. 2 years later, they had a law that said that the LPG that they had to be of a certain composition. And so 18 million people kind of benefited from the research that our group did. And now we've done a lot of work in China, where the Environmental Protection Bureau have used guidance from our group and others to try and improve air quality. While our air pollution studies are important, and those can affect local and regional air quality for people, the 800-pound gorilla here is climate change. That is going to affect everybody in the world. The whole world needs to get on board to try and reduce our emissions. I cannot say enough about my mentor. Sherwood Rowland was the first chairman of the chemistry department. He was an incredible scientist, an incredible person. A lot of the way I do things is a result of how he did things. 10 years after he came here, he makes this incredible discovery that CFCs could destroy stratospheric ozone. That then, 20 years later, was rewarded with the Nobel Prize in 1995. Well, I've been here almost 40 years at UCI. One of the things I'm most proud of is the fact that I have worked hard, been successful at what I do, and that work has led to laws and regulations and knowledge that has allowed people in the United States and other countries to improve their air quality. Having good air quality is a right that we all should have.